Hello children, good day to you all. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, The Literature Teacher. Once again, we are going to discuss a prose passage, an extract from Colin Cowdery lecture, The Lahore Attack by Kumar Sangakkara, which is one of the most favorite prose passage of yours. The Lahore Attack. Dear children, the title says an extract from the Colin Cowdery lecture, The Lahore Attack. But dear children, when you are writing an extraction, pute, no need to write that an extract from Colin Cowdery lecture, because if you feel like writing, it's okay, but you have to have a very understanding, and you have to be very much accurate on what? Capitalization, punctuation, and spelling from the beginning to the end. So then, that is my advice for you all. When you write the A part of an extraction question, dear children, you write just The Lahore Attack, all the three words starting from capital letters, and then just write the writer's name, Kumar Sangakkara. It is Kumar Sangakkara, not Kumara. Right, okay, shall we have a look on the text? I was fortunate that during my life, I never experienced violence in Sri Lanka firsthand. You know what is the basic base of this his speech? Now, they were attacked in 2009, right, on 3rd March in Pakistan. You know, that was the time of climax in Sri Lankan civil war, right? During that time, heavy attack was going on in Sri Lanka, right? You can see these pictures even, how terrible and violent those attacks were. Right, that kind of situation was prevailed in Sri Lanka during that time in 2009. And Sri Lankan cricket team, our national heroes, they were attacked. I mean, the bus they were carrying was attacked or fired upon by 12 gunmen near Gaddafi Stadium in Lahore. Right, Pakistani gunmen, right? There were 12 of them, and cricketers were on their way to play the third day of the second test against the Pakistani cricket team, right? Six members of the Sri Lankan cricket team were injured, six Pakistani policemen and two civilians were reported as killed. So it was not an easy moment for anybody, right? But somehow, luckily, our team was able to escape, right? So, by listening and learning these things, dear children, don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel, and please make a comment and make it like, right? I was fortunate. Mama harima vasanavantai, that during my life I never experienced violence in Sri Lanka firsthand. Sri Lanka villa kota jeevithe kavadavat firsthand violence ekata mama mona dunne naha. So he was very frank and honest man, dear children, you know. Now he is in front of an international gathering, right? The whole focus was on him. He could have told so many things regarding this one, but he was really a true to heart man, and he was really a frank man. He says everything in his mind which is true, right? There have been so many bomb explosions over the years, but I was never in the wrong place at the wrong time. Bomb explosions, I think you may have heard about these things puthe lankawa hama tanama indala hitla atanin metanin bomba pipuruna jeevitha vinasha una deepala hani una so many things happened right but he says I was never in the wrong place at the wrong time varadi velawaka varadi tanaka velawa narak vechi velawaka mama hima tanaka hitiyena enisa mata first hand experience me violence ekak mehemai meke dukha mehemai this is how it was going on this is the suffering it's really painful he could have told but being an honest man he says that I'm not aware about this first hand experience right in Colombo apart from these occasional bombs life was relatively normal people had the luxury of being physically detached from the war te yuddhe tibune kohede uturu med uturu patte uturu med palatata kittu wenda uturu patte uturu karene jaffna side ekene habai api hite in Colombo so that geographical distance keeps these people out of the danger right ara yuddha peramune hitapu minisun saha soldiers la pute ananta duk vindina kota meya kiyana children went to school people went to work I played my cricket rataka ekka kotasak a kind of people in the same country they were highly suffering from this kind of civil war but because of the distance from the war zone these people had the luxury of having their daily routine as usual that's what he says he feels guilty conscious regarding these things children went to school people went to work I played my cricket right in other parts of the country though people were putting their lives in harm's way every day either in the defense of their motherland or just trying to survive the geographical circumstances that made them inhabit a war zone so you think about the situation pute now let's see that those pictures again api ara pictures tika aya poddak balamu look at the violence look at the pain these innocent civilians are suffering from what is the wrong they have done to suffer like that e minissu karapu aradak naha daruwane but that was the situation innocent children right old people ladies men whatever they are they were suffering to the climax right look at the pictures that the soldiers were there what is their life dear children what kind of a life they were living in such kind of a war zone war torn area to kota pute soldiers la vitarak nevey war zone ekaka jeevathvime avasanawa karapinna gat minisun they were suffering at large right okay for them avoiding bullets shells mines and grenades was imperative for survival kawda pute them kiyala kiyanne who are them refer to those two kinds of people dear children remember that carefully right them in the sense or not only the soldiers at the war front but the civilians at the war front okay this was an experience that I could not relate to I had great sympathy and compassion for them but had no real experience with which I could draw parallels right e minisunta pute bullets walin grenades walin shell wedi walin me wagen beerene ka tamai api ape war zone eken aath vechi minisu pute they are planning they are thinking and wondering how to spend the day right what my works today what is my daily routine to be ehema kalpana karana kota pute right mokadda me minisu karanne me minisu pute ara kadeeta gihilla haal kilo ekak aragena enakota mata live gedara enna puluwang weida oya ana athare landmine ekata ahu weida shell wedi parakkin merila wateida kiyala danne nathuwa jeevath vechi minisun kotasa apeema rate apeema bhumiye hitiya so Sangakkara said I had sympathy and compassion mata loku aadareyak anukampawak eda indama tibuna but had no real experience namuth e experience ekak me wage kiyala kiyanda I don't have examples that's what he says okay shall we listen to the original words of Sangakkara for a while. Okay.
I was fortunate that during my life, I never experienced violence in Sri Lanka firsthand. There had been so many bomb explosions over the years, but I was never in the wrong place at the wrong time. In Colombo, apart from these occasional bombs, life was relatively normal. People had the luxury of being physically detached from the war. Children went to school, people went to work, and I played my cricket. In other parts of the country, though, people were putting their lives in harm's way every day, either in the defense of their motherland or just trying to survive the geographical circumstances that made them inhabit a war zone. For them, avoiding bullets, shells, mines, and grenades was imperative for survival. This was an experience I could not relate to. I had great sympathy and compassion for them, but I had no real experience from which I could draw parallels.
That was until we toured in Pakistan in 2009. Experience එකක් මට violence ගැන තිබුණේ නැත්තේ අපි පාකිස්තානයේ tour එක 2009 යනකල්. We set off to play two tests in Karachi and Lahore. The first test played on a featherbed pass without great incident. කිසිම නරක කිසිම special incident එකක් නැතුව. Can we see the pictures? Right? අපි අපේ match එක play කරා. You can see how they were traveling and how they were playing in the field. Right? Okay. The second test was meandering along. You know that the nature of test matches and the one-day series, right? It's not that much exciting. Test matches are not that much exciting like the one-day series, dear children. So it's somewhat boring, I feel. Right? Second test was meandering along with us piling up a big first innings when we departed for the ground on day 3. දවල් 3 වෙනි දවස වෙනුවෙන් හෙට දවසට අපි ground එකකින් පිටත් වෙලා යනකොට we had a very big challenge, right? Match එක ගොඩ ගන්න නම් මොනවාද වෙලා තිබුණේ? First inning එක ලොකු ගාණක් ගහලා තියෙන දැති. අපිට තිබුණ challenge එක having been asked to leave early instead of waiting for the Pakistan bus. Now you know Pakistan was the host. So normally those two buses were leaving their residential premises at once. But on that special day, this Sri Lankan team, they were given an order to leave early without waiting for the Pakistani bus. They will be coming later, right? We were anticipating a day of hard toil for the bowlers. Eda davase match ekak goda ganne ka thirane vela thibune bowlers late, right? මොකද අරගොල්ල සෑහෙන ලකුණු ප්‍රමාණයක් අරන් තියෙන්නේ ඇති ෆස්ට් ඉනින් එකේ. ඒගොල්ලන් ඉක්මනින් කඩා ගන්න නම් බෝලර්ස්ලා අතේ තමයි දැනටමත් යාලා ලොකු ගාණක් ගහලානේ. බෝලර්ස්ට තමයි වැඩේ තිබුණේ. Right? At the back of the bus, the fast bowlers were loud in their complaints like you all. බස් එකේ පිටිපස්සේ ඉඳගෙන හිටිය අපේ fast bowlers-ලා set එක. So they know that there is a big burden on our shoulder today. Right? So it was a stressful for them even. So that's why they were making their complaints, right? I remember Tilan Tushara being particularly vocal. Meka hari mukari katakarai talkative witty, complaining that his back was near breaking point. Ammo mage konda kadenda onda menna adanang. So they were so tired after playing several days, right? And the mental stress was higher than that physical stress, right? That's why he says what? He joked that he wished a bomb would go off so we could all leave Lahore and go back home. That's it, dear children. He joked. Vihiluwata kiwwe monada? Ayyo bomb ekak gahanna yanne me Lahore walin ipita vela gedara gihin gedara yanda apita. That's what he said, right? Not 30 seconds had passed when we heard what sounded like firecrackers going off. Firecrackers going off. Oya ara ane deyene me bomb ekakwat gahanne naha ne kiyala Tilan Tushara kiwwat hari ka para tappara 30ක් ගියේ නෑ. Wedi wadinawa wage apita sound ekak ehuna. Suddenly a shout came from the front, get down, they are shooting at the bus. Bus එක ඉස්සරහින් අපිට ලොකු sound එකක් ඇදුනා, හැදුනා, ඇහුණා. මොකටද? පහත් වෙන්න, get down, they are shooting at the bus. What can you say about the joke? Okay, shall we move into the next video of Sangakkara?
That was until we toured Pakistan in 2009. We set off to play two tests in Karachi and Lahore. The first test played on a featherbed, passed without great incident. The second test was also meandering along with us piling up a big first innings when we departed for the ground on day three. Having been asked to leave early, instead of waiting for the Pakistan bus, we were anticipating a hard day of toil for the bowlers. At the back of the bus, the fast bowlers were loud in their complaints. I remember Tilan Tushara being particularly vocal, complaining that his back was near breaking point, and he joked, and I kid you not, that he wished a bomb would go off so we could all leave Lahore and go back home. Not 30 seconds had passed when we heard what sounded like firecrackers going off. Suddenly a shout came from the front, get down, they are shooting at the bus.
Okay. The reaction was immediate. Apit tehemane pute, ewa ge deyak ahunoth tehema reaction eka mokadda? Immediate ne? Right, everyone died for the cover and took shelter on the easel or behind the seats. Ara loku luxury bus eke මැද පිටිපස්සට යන පැත්තේ සීට්ස් දෙකක් මැද then on top of each other with a very little space we were all lying on top of each other right එකිනෙකා මත අපි lie down වුණා මෙතන ටීම් එකට මේ 11ක් හෝ 12ක් right ඔගොල්ලෝ දන්නවා so there were some representatives from Sri Lanka there were paramedics coaches somebody from some officials from the sports ministry, cricket council, whatever. Lot of people were there, right? So then what happened? Then the bullets started to hit. Now you just think about the situation. They were inside the bus, lying down on top of each other because the space was very limited there, right? The bullets started to hit. It was like rain on tin roof. The bus was at a standstill, an easy target for the gunmen. Okay, you can see the pictures now, right? Pictures. Here you can see two gunmen. Okay, and they were shooting at the bus. This is how the bullet thuds, right? And went inside the bus through the window, right? As bullets started, now, putte ara hariyata tahadu wahalekata, neda? Vassa watana kota eka dikata ahenawa wage apita wedi wadinawa. The bus was at a standstill. The bus ekak yanne neha. Bus ekak eka tana. Right? An easy target for the gunmen. Why not? Meka bomba gahanawa nemeyne putte. Wedi tiyanne. Etakota move novana bus ekata object ekata wedi tiyena ke easy target ekak. As bullets started bursting through the bus, all we could do was stay still and quiet. අපිට කරන්න තිබුණු එකම දේ ඔහි සද්ද නැතුව quiet ඉන්න එක නිස්කලංකව ඉන්න එක hoping and praying to avoid death or injury. Death or injury. අනේ දෙයනේ අපිට තිබුණු එකම දේ අපිට කිසිම කරදරයක් මරණයක් තුමවාලයක් වෙන්න එපා කියලා prarthana karan ekak vitarai. Suddenly Mahela, who sits at the back of the bus, shouts saying he thinks he has been hit in the shin. Pitipasse saddayak awa Mahela gen. Mahela manawada kiwwe? Pitipasse indan kaya gahuwa ayata wedi waduna shin. Mokada puthe shin kiyala kiyanne me front part of the leg from knee to the ankle. Mata wedi waduna mage kakulata kiyala kaya gahuwa. As I turn my head, sorry. I am lying next to Tilan. Now you see how you have to have the visual imagery. I am lying next to Tilan. Tilan Tushara neda den ara particularly vocal man. K කිව්වේ බෝම්බ එකක්වත් ගහන්න නැහැ නේ කියලා කිව්වේ එයාට ළඟම වාඩි වෙලා එයා වාඩි වෙලා නෙවෙයි වැතිරිලා ඉන්නවා මම he groans in pain as a bullet hits him in the back of his thigh අයියෝ back of his thigh තට්ටමේ පිටිපස්සට බුලට් එකක් වැදලා තිලාන් තුෂාරගේ right කොහොමද ජෝක් එක as I turn my head දැන් ඒ තමන් ළඟම ඉන්න මිනිස්සයා දැන් අයියෝ වේදන බුලට් එකක් වැදෙනවා කියන එක සෙල්ලමක් වේදනාවෙන් කෙඳිරි ගන්නකොට I as I turn my head to look at him feel something whiz past my ear මම මෙහෙම ඉන්න සංගපුතේ ඔළුවත් එක්ක බිමට නමාගෙන වැතිරිලා ඉන්නකොට තිලාන් තුෂාර එහා පැත්තේ ඉඳන් දැන් ගෙඳිරි ගන්නවනේ කේය ගන්නවනේ එයාව බලන්න මෙහෙම හරවනකොටම මාගේ කන ළඟින් whiz past something whiz past my ear and a bullet thuds into the side of the sea මේ කන ගාවින් ගියා කියලා අපි කියන්නේ කන ගාවින් බුලට් එකක් ගියා ගිහින් වැදුනා සීට් එකේ සයිඩ් එකක that exact spot where my head had been a few seconds earlier මෙහෙම තියාගෙන හිටියානම් අනිවාර්යෙන් මේවා කියන්න සංගක්කාර කෙනෙක් නැහැ පුතේ අපිට right හොඳ වෙලාවට තිලාන් තුෂාරට වැදුනේ කියලා තමයි හැමදේම everything happens for a good sake නේ එහෙම කියලා අපි හිතමු ඔළුව හැරෙව්වේ නැතිනම් තමන්ගේ ඔළුව ඉස්සල්ලා තිබිච්ච පොසිෂන් එකේ තිබුණා නම් බුලට් එක ඔළුවට වදිනවා පුතේ හරවපු හින්දා කන ගාවින් ගියා තප්පර කීපයකට කලින් right okay let's listen to him
the reaction was immediate everyone died for cover and took shelter on the aisle or behind the seats with very little space we were lying on top of each other then the bullet started to hit it was like rain on a tin roof the bus was at a standstill an easy target for the gunman as bullets started bursting through the bus all we could do was lay still stay quiet hoping and praying to avoid death or injury Suddenly, Mahela, who sits right at the back of the bus, shouts, saying he thinks he has been hit in the shin. I'm lying next to Tilan. He groans in pain as a bullet hits him in the back of his thigh. I turn my head to look at him. I feel something whiz past my ear, and a bullet thuds into the side of the seat, the exact spot where my head was a second ago.
I feel something hit my shoulder. Ara oluwa. ඔළුව හරවනකොටම කන ගාවින් ගියා හැබැයි ඒත් එක්කම මගේ ෂෝල් එකට වැදුනා and goes it numb it goes numb හිරි වැටිලා ගියා right I know I had been hit මට තේරුණා මට වෙඩි වැදුනා but I was just relieved and praying I was not going to be hit in the head හැබැයි මට ලොකු සැනසීමක් තුන කමක් නැහැ ඔර හිසටනේ වැදුනේ ඔළුව බේරුණානේ පුතේ can you think about think like that Can anybody? අපිට පුළුවන් දෙහෙම හිතන්න. ඇඟිල්ලක් කැපුණා තමෝ කියලා හිතන අපි. කමක් නැහැ උරහිසටනේ වැදුනේ. ඔළුවට බේරුණානේ ඔළුවට නොවැදී බේරුණානේ කියලා හිතනවා. I think that is the courage and bravery and the I mean his disciplined life gained from the sportsmanship. That may be. Right? තරංග පරණ විතාන on his debut tour is also next to me. මේ වේදනාවල් ඔක්කොම දරාගෙන හිටියා පුතේ තරංග පරණ විතානත් මංගාව තමයි හිටියේ he stands up අප්පෝ තිලාන් තුෂාර තමන් මේ තුන් දෙනා එක ළඟ හිටියේ තිලාන් තුෂාරට වැදුනා සංගක්කාරට වැදුනා සමහර විට මේක නෑ දරා ගන්නම බැරි වෙන්න ඇති පුතේ හැමෝගෙම mentalities එක වගේ නෙමේ he stands up bullets flying all around him නැගිට්ටම bullets වදින්නේ නැද්ද shouting I have been hit සමහරට මෙයාට එයා හිටපු පොසිෂන් එක වෙන්න පුළුවන් එහෙම නැත්නම් නැගිටට පස්සේ වැදුනා වෙන්නත් පුළුවන් shouting I have been hit as he hauls his blood soaked chest අයියෝ මට වැදුනා පපුවට වැදුනා blood soaked ලේ උතුරනවා ගලනවා he collapsed onto his seat apparently unconscious අර නැගිටපු මිනිස්සයා එහෙමම සීට් එකක් උඩට සිහි නැතුව කඩන් වැටුණා I see him and I think මං එයාව බලලා මෙහෙම හිතනවා Oh my god you were out first ball run out the next innings and now you have been shot hiyo first tour ekalu taranga parana vitanage right deyene me manusya first ball em out vela pau lakunak atharata inda beru vela ilangata run out the next innings ilange inimedi lakunu nolabama run out ekak gehilla now you have been shot then me yakata vedith edila so that's a joke What a terrible first tour. Hani deyene mara first tour ekak ne. ලස්සනට අවසන් වෙන්න තිබිච්ච තැනක් නේද? It's strange how clear your thinking is. එහෙම හිතන්න අපිටත් පුළුවන් වෙන්නයි ඕන. He thinks so. එයාම කියනවා ඒ වගේ වෙලාවට තමන් අපේ thinking මනස කොයි විදිහද වැඩ කරන්නේ කියන එක හරි අමුතුයි. I did not see my life flash by. මම දැක්කේ නෑ මගේ ජීවිතේ මුල ඉඳන් අඟට අද වෙනකල් මම පසු කරගෙන මරණයේ මොහොතේ කොයි වෙලේ කොයි විදිහට මැරිලා වැටේද කියන්න දන්නේ නැති මොහොතක් උතේ. It's a kind of fight between life and death. That moment was so critical, but Sangha, with clear mind, he thinks about the others. Right? He wishes not to make any injury, seriousness of others. There was no insane panic. There was absolute clarity and awareness of what was happening at the moment. Utae api jeevithayema hard moments walata face karano. අපි අද හાર્ඩ් මොමන්ට් එකක නොවන තැනකදී අපි හිතනවා අම්මෝ මට නම් ඒ වගේ තැන් දරා ගන්න බැරි වෙයි කියලා. But absolute clarity. අපේ මයින්ඩ් එක මේ human mind is so amazing පුතේ. අපි අද බහැයි කියලා හිතා ගන්න තැන් වලට අපි ඇත්තටම මුහුණ දෙනකොට we tend to face courageously. Right? That's what happened. I hear the bus roaring to life and start to move. මට ඇහුණ බස් එක ආයේ start වෙනවා. Dilshan is screaming at the driver, drive, drive. Mata ahuna Dilshan, driver ta kaya gahanawa, drive, drive. We speed up, swerve and are finally inside the safety of the inside. Antimedi, driver bus eka pana ganwa gane etanin aawa. Api kohoma hari stadium ekata aawa. Let's see the pictures. Now, because of this driver's courageousness, now being the Pakistani man, he tried to save this Sri Lankan national team. All respect must go to him. Me manusya nouna nan pute ape minissu marana kan wedi thiyena. Right? Let's listen to the video.
I feel something hit my shoulder and it goes numb. I know I had been hit. But I was just relieved and praying I was not going to be hit in the head. Taranga Parnavithan on his debut tour is also next to me. He stands up, bullets flying all around him, shouting, I just got hit. As he holds his blood-soaked chest, he collapses into his seat, apparently unconscious. Now this is his debut tour, and I see him, and I think, oh my God, you were out first ball, run out in the next innings, and now you have been shot. What a terrible, terrible first tour. It is strange how clear your thinking is. I did not see my life flash by. There was no insane panic. There was absolute clarity and awareness of what was happening at that moment.
There is a rush to get off the bus. Now they are in the stadium. දැන් ඉතින් මෙච්චර වෙලා ඉවසගෙන හිටපු මිනිස්සු ටිකට දොරෙන් එළියට බහගන්න ලොකු කලබලයක් ආවා. තරංග පරණවිතාන stands up, unconscious හිටපු මිනිස්සයා stands up. He is still bleeding and has a bullet lodged lightly in his sternum. Sternum කියලා අපි කියන්නේ පුතේ මේ පපු මේ මැද තියෙන මේ ඇටය කියලා කියන්නේ. Right? Sternum කියලා කියන්නේ breast bone එක. අන්න එතෙන්ට තමයි වැදෙලා තිබුණේ. Right? The body of the bus tempering its velocity enough to be stopped by the bone. ekena puthe den bullet ekak enne bus ekke body ekak pasaru karagirene etakota ara bullet ekak wadena pravege velocity ekak adu wenawa e nisa wenna athi breast bone ekak gawin bullet ekak nawathila thibuna kada gena heart ekak lungs patthara gihin thibuna giya nan iwarai ne e nisa ara bullet ekak gunmen bullet ekak tibbahama bus ekke body ekak neda පසාරු කරගෙන එනකොට වේගය අඩු වෙලා ඒකයි කියන්නේ පුතේ tempering its velocity enough to be stopped by the bone. Right? Tilan is helped off the bus. Tilan එළියට ගත්තා. දැන් මේ ගොල්ලන්ට කොහෙද වෙඩි වැදුනේ කවුද මේ කියන එක පුතේ? You have to remember, right? You have to be specific when you are given an extraction in such kind of places. So we see කියලා වම් කියන්න ඕනේ, right? Tilan is helped off the bus. In the dressing room, there is a mixture of emotions. Then dressing room, emotions. This was a serious and critical moment for them. And they never have been subjected to violence before. It was the first-hand experience. I'm serious. Anger, relief, joy, samaharu tarahe, samaharu ammo athi antan kiyenawa, samaharu satutin hina wenawa. Athi antan beruna kiyala hitenawa, neida? Players and coaching staff are being examined by paramedics. Ara players la wathin egulanwa check kara puthe paramedics la innawa egulanta. Tilan and Paranavithan are taken by ambulance to the hospital. Shall we see the pictures? Right? Ambulance came megalangwa genichcha puthe hospital ekata. You see the pictures? Right? Okay. We all sit in the dressing room and talk. Api okkoma dressing room eke indagena katha karanawa. Talked about what happened. Api mokadda une kiyala katha kala. Within minutes, there is laughter and the jokes started to flow. How courageous nation we are, pute. May we not keep our jokes in our hatara thing. We have for the first time been a target of violence. We had survived. Palaveni vatavat api target ekakuna violence wala. Habai api survive una. We all realize that what some of our fellow Sri Lankans experienced every day for nearly 30 years. Api hamotama therna, who are we? Right? If you get such kind of a question, we, who are we? Api kiyanne kawuda? Sangha and the team members of the cricket team. Right? Apita hamotama theruna monawada appema rate minisun sankhyawa pirisa. Right? Ekthar ek rataka ekama pirisak thawa ek pirisak cricket gahadi thawa pirisak mona taram dukak vindada kiyala apita eda thamai therune. There was a new respect and awe for their courage and selflessness. අපිට අපේ හිත්වල වෙන දටත් වැඩිය අර වෝටෝන් සෝන් එකේ ජීවත් වෙච්ච මිනිසුන් සහ සෝල්ජර්ස්ලා ගැන පුදුම රෙස්පෙක්ට් එකක් තිබුණා. Okay, let's listen.
Tilan is helped off the bus. In the dressing room there's a mixture of emotions. There is anger, relief, joy. Players and coaching staff are being examined by paramedics. Tilan and Parnavithana are taken by ambulance to hospital. We all sit in the dressing room and talk. Talk about what happened. Within minutes, there is laughter and the jokes have started to flow. We have, for the first time, been a target of violence and we had survived. We all realize that some of our fellow Sri Lankans, we all realize that what some of our Sri Lankans experienced every day for nearly 30 years had just happened to us. There was a new respect and awe for their courage and selflessness.
It's notable how quickly we got over that attack on us. Habai api hari notable pute api hari ikmanin me attack eken miduna vinadi kipeyai. Although we were physically injured, mentally we held strong. Api kipa denakota tuwala una, physically injured una, habai mentally api wadune neha. So, may popularity ke climax kala yak Sri Lankan team ekata after 1996 having their World Cup also. And the situation of Sri Lanka was critical. That was the climax of the civil war, right? May monade tibunath api manasika api vetune ne. A few hours later, the attack, we were airlifted to the Lahore Air Force Base. Api were guwanin genicha Air Force Base ekata. Ajanta Mendis, I think you have seen the picture. His head swathed in bandages after multiple shrapnel wounds. Suggests a game of poker. Tuwala dakkana puthe oluwe neida? Tuwala ithin ehema ehe wadilla tuwala vela ehema atte. Hari nikan game of poker wage tamai lo dakke. Tilan has been brought back and Tilan unath genalla. Sedated but fully conscious to be with us and we make jokes at him and he smiles back. Thattumata ne wadune neida? ඉතින් ඔය විකාර විහිළුවක් කළා හිනාවෙන්න ඇති. We were shot at. Grenades were thrown at us. We were injured. And yet, we were not covered. අපිට තුවාල වුණා, අපිට grenades ගැහුවා, අපිට වෙඩි තිබ්බා. හැබැයි අපි බය ගොල්ලෝනේ නෑ. We were not down and out. අපි පුතේ පැරදුනේ නෑ. අපි වැටුනේ නෑ. We are Sri Lankan. We thought to ourselves. අපි ශ්‍රී ලාංකිකයෝ. And we are tough, and we will get through hardships, and we will overcome because our spirit is strong. Api tough. Api me nikan sini bola wage venena jaatiyak neme. Apita karadara dukkam kadunu hondara purudui. Right? Api meken overcome wenawa because our spirit is strong. Mokada ape spirit ekak bohoma shaktimat. This is what the world saw in our interviews immediately after the attack. මෙන්න මේකයි පුතේ ලෝකය දැක්කේ අපි හරිම ශක්තිමත් ජාතියක් they did not complain anybody so now being the host pakistani being the host they could have complained right okay complain කරේ නෑ පුතේ චෝදනා කරේ නෑ අපිට සත්කාර කරේ නෑ අපිට වෙඩිත් තිබ්බා අපි මෙහෙම කරා අපිට වන්දි දෙන්න කියලා ප්‍රශ්න ඇති කරේ නෑ පුතේ we were calm collected and rational api hemom ekama mana hadawathin hitiye our emotions held true to our role as unofficial ambassadors puthe metana ahana tana you will get a question to brief this line unofficial ambassadors you know who ambassadors are they are the people who represents a country right they represent a country okay etakota me golanta ehema thanapati waru wage nilanolat ai me gollo thamai they have brought the sri lankanness to the whole world they have become representative of Sri Lankans in front of the world so that's why they call as unofficial ambassadors a week after our arrival in Colombo from Pakistan then me Pakistan indala awatat passe satiyekata vithara passe I was driving about town and was stopped at a checkpoint Colombo man wahane padawagene athana athuruthura checkpoint ekama awa nawaththuwa A soldier politely inquired as to my health after the attack. Ethana hitapu soldier. Obathumata kohomada kiyala ahanna hati. I said I was fine and added that what they as soldiers experience every day. We only experience for a few minutes. Ethekkama uman hodin kiyana kathawata add kara puthe. Oyala soldiers la vidihata hemadaama dakina de. Atvindina de. Api ithin vinadi kīpayai atvinde. But managed to grab all the news headlines. නමුත් අපිට පුළුවන්කම තිබුණා හැම හෙඩ්ලයින් එකකම ලෝකේ හැම පුවත්පතකම හැම නිවුස් එකකම හෙඩ්ලයින් එක වෙන්න. That soldier looked me in the eye. He soldier මන් දිහා ඇස් දෙක අරගෙන ලොකු ඇස් දෙක ලොකු කරන් බලන් හිටියා and replied it's okay if I die. මම මැරුණට කමක් නෑ. Right? Because it's my job. ඒක මගේ රස්සාවනේ. And I'm ready for it. Mang ekata lasti. But you are a hero. Etoba thuma veerek. If you were to die, it would be a great loss for our country. Oba thuma veerek. Oba thuma nathuwa giyot. Eka ape ratata loku paaduwa. Puthe, that's why. That's how these innocent soldiers were brainwashed. Eka thama yalata deela thibichi ekama de puthe. Merenda rassa thiyenawada? Right? Okay I was taken aback mama nikan para gehuwa wage mata apassara visiyuna how can this man value his life less than mine me manusaya kohomada mage jeevithayata wada eyaage jeevithaye pahath kota salakanne his sincerity was overwhelming I felt humble eke manusaya mawa dakkakamata nikan boruwata kiyapu kathawak nevey sangakkata danuna eka hadawathin maapu kathawak I felt humble mata man ganawa heenamanayak aawa puthe This is the passion that cricket and cricketers evoke in Sri Lankans. Oka thamai Lankawa minisunge cricket welta saha cricketers lata thiyena aadare. This is the love that I strive every day of my career to be worthy of. Mage rakiyawata mage vurthiyata man hemadaama elena bandena ekama de onna okai. Nothing else. He truly says. Right? Shall we listen to the next video?
It is notable how quickly we got over that attack. Although we were physically injured, mentally we held strong. A few hours after the attack, we were lifted to the Lahore Air Force Base. Ajanta Mendis, his head swathed in bandages after multiple shrapnel wounds, suggests a game of poker. Tilan had been brought back, sedated but fully conscious, to be with us. And we make jokes at him, and he smiles back. We were shot. Grenades were thrown at us. We were injured. And yet, we were not cowed. We were not down and out. We are Sri Lankan, we thought to ourselves. And we are tough. And we will get through hardship. And we will overcome because our spirit is strong. This is what the world saw in our interviews immediately after the attack. We were calm. We were collected and rational. Our emotions held true to our role as unofficial ambassadors. A week after arrival in Colombo from Pakistan, I was driving in Colombo. And I was stopped at a checkpoint. A soldier politely inquired as to my health after the attack. I said I was fine and added that what they as soldiers experienced every day, we experienced only for a few minutes, but still managed to grab all the headlines. He looked me in the eye and he said, "It is okay. It is okay if I die, because it is my job and I'm ready for it. But you are a hero. And if you were to die, it would be a great loss for our country." I was taken aback. How can this man value his life less than mine? His sincerity was overwhelming. I felt humbled. This is the passion that cricket and cricketers evoke in Sri Lankans. This is the love that I strive every day of my career to be worthy of.
Okay, these are several points you need to know and you need to elaborate in the questions, Pute. Sangha as a leader. So these, I have here given you some points. Brave, unity, cooperation, thinking and caring of others, team spirit, empathy, strong mentality, humbleness, positive thinking, courage. So those are some of the features. Now you have to, please do have evidences from the text to say that, to prove that he is a brave man, to prove that he has the team spirit and empathy and all. Right. What about this, dear children? Sangha as a true human? Avanka manusek, caring and sharing. එයාට ෂොට් වෙලා වෙඩි වැදිලා තියෙදිත් එයා අනිත් අය ගැන බැලුවා. ට්‍රූ ටු හාර්ට් නේචර් අවංකවම ප්‍රකාශ කරපු අදහස්. ඔනස්ටි, පේට්‍රියොටික් රට ගැන තිබුණ වියා ශ්‍රී ලංකන් නේද? ඔප්ටිමිස්ටික් නේචර්. ඕ ඉට්ස් ඕකේ. මෙතන මට වැදුනට කමන්නේ ඔළුව බේරුණානේ. He's away from vanity. This is a very popular figure in the higher pedestal of the society, social ladder even. But he's away from vanity. Empathy. True human. So, please have the evidences from the text. Shall we look on one of the extractions? Right. 2016 I have selected here, Pute. Let's see the quotation. "It's okay if I die because it's my job and I'm ready for it. But you are a hero. And if you were to die, it would be a great loss for the country." From which text is this extract taken? Who wrote it? The Lahore Attack by Kumar Sangakkara. Who speaks these words? The soldier at the checkpoint in Colombo. Pute etana, who speaks these words? The soldier kiyala vitarak thibunata nan lakunu dunne neha. Soldier at the checkpoint in Colombo tamai complete answer eka. To whom karada meva kiyanne? To Sangha. Sangakkara. What is the speaker's feeling? Speaker kaw the soldier ne feeling towards the person. And soldier ge hite sangha gana tibitcha feeling ne kane ahanne. It is the respect, honor, admiration, high regard, appreciation. Putte mangwa slashes madde dala thiyena wachana okkoma liyanna kiyala nevey kiyanne. What is the speaker's feeling? At least one you can use, but you need to describe within two lines. Okay. Adoration towards Sangakkara. Hope you got the points. Right? Critical question ekak balamuda api. Sangakkara is a true portrayal of human who is molded by the sportsmanship. Discuss in relation to the Lahore attack by Kumar Sangakkara. Look at the question properly, dear children. Sangakkara is a true portrayal of human ආන්න දැන් අර ප්‍රසංග ඇස හියුමන් කියන පොයින්ට් එකනේ පුතේ අපි මේ ඩිස්කස් කරන්නේ. Show the true feelings of Sangha as a human. In the introduction, you can just mention what are the human qualities of Sangha that you are going to describe. True to heart nature. Pute oyalata evidence arang prove karanna puluwa human characteristic kipayak ganna. Right? True to heart nature, honesty, patriotism, optimism, caring of others, whatever. Then show how he behaved even at the hard moment during the attack, which is molded by his sportsmanship. Puthe etana apita thiyena molded by the sportsmanship. That is not only the portrayal of human values of Sangha. Sangakkara ge thibuna manusa gati guna vitarak nemei puthe ahanne. Vicha me molded by the sportsmanship. E qualities yata labune sportsmanship nisa kiyala kiyannone. Kridawings ekena api daruwanta kridawa karanna kiyanne. Show how he behaved. Ekena ara hard moment ekak pawa puthe bohoma ivasime panic novi then sanga okkoma kalin berihan dila ayyo iwarai man iwarai mata waduna kiyala berihan dila scene athuwa watuna nan anith eunge courage ekata mokada wenne daruwane neda that must be a leader. The qualities he displays reflect the humanity in him, which is shaped by the sportsmanship. Me hama deema puthe yage hasirime yage kathawa ya thinking pattern එක මේ හැමදේම shape කරේ sportsmanship එකත් එක්ක. So you have to have an organization pattern, write and write your answer. Okay, that's the end of the Lahore attack, my dear children, right? Hope you have